Back up now to Govan Hill in Glasgow, where earlier we met Lorraine and David, who for bang on the bargain guide price of £30,000 had bought this classic one-bed Glasgow tenement flat. This was their first venture into property renovation, and they had a simple renovate and sell on plan, with Lorraine being the project manager. Lorraine was clearly full of enthusiasm for her first project. We've returned 4 months later to see the results. The new kitchen is modern and practical. By moving the sink and creating a window seat in its place, Lorraine has created a clean and spacious feel here. The living room has been stripped right back and repainted, with the original features restored, just as Lorraine promised. A fresh carpet leads out into the bright, clean hallway, where the superior finish continues. The bedroom that once felt cramped and dingy has now been opened up and cleaned up. Across the hallway, the tired old bathroom with a hole in the floor and a smell of damp is now, well, see for yourself. By replacing the damaged floorboards and laying attractive floor tiles found at a reclamation yard, as well as painting and replastering, Lorraine and David have achieved a good finish here. They decided against turning it into a two-bed, and to be honest, the cost of doing that may have eaten into any profit they were likely to make. I am really impressed by what's been done to this property, and particularly so by the rejigging in the kitchen.
Traditionally in tenements, the sink would be here, and in fact it would block part of the window off, and it just seemed a shame to lose that feature. So my very clever husband David suggested that we put in a window seat, and my builder Stephen actually built it, designed this and put it in, and I decorated it with scatter cushions.
Not only have Lorraine and David transformed their flat, but by talking to the factor, the Scottish term for the communal maintenance company, they got the stairs and the close painted and improved. And they've enhanced the curb appeal by tidying up the area in the front of the flats. The communal areas at the back are the council's responsibility and are due for renovation in the near future. I cannot fault their attention to detail, so break it down for me, Lorraine. Let's start from the beginning.
We had to rip out the kitchen, lift up some of the floorboards, re-skim the walls, and in the bathroom, pretty much the same. There was a damp patch on the ceiling which needed to be sealed and made good, which we had done, and then put down some lovely slate tiles, which I'd bought from a reclamation yard, which I got a really good deal on, which I was very happy about. I think those are my two favourite rooms because they've got the biggest transformation. They look really nice. I wouldn't mind living there. All the doors in the flat were all the original Victorian doors, but they'd been hidden with plasterboard and all kinds of stuff. So we had those ripped off, and then the doors were taken away and dipped and stripped back to their original as they'd have been in the early 1900s. I love the character. You know, it's a one-bedroom flat, but it's just got oodles of character with the ceiling roses and the cornicing and the original doors. Because I'm happy. Clap along if you feel like a room
without a roof. Because I'm happy. Clap along if Lorraine has project managed from her home in London, visiting frequently over the four-month renovation period. So how has she found her first project?
I think project managing generally, I mean, I come from the background of advertising. I worked in ad agencies most of my career, so that was my job. So I'm used to juggling lots of balls in the air. You just make it work. It's like any job. You just have to make it work.
Lorraine's attention to detail and her research meant that she brought this project in at £14,000, £1,000 under her original budget. Now, I loved this flat before, but I think Lorraine has added value in all the right places. How does she feel now that it's all over?
It feels like a home, which it didn't. When I bought it at auction, it was a bomb site. And walking into the kitchen and the bathroom, it just feels really cosy. And I think, although you can't take it too personally, you know, I'm not buying this and doing this for me to live in, I think you can still have a sense of pride about what you're doing and still have that, gosh, I wouldn't mind living here if I was not married 10 years younger. I'm based in Scotland, but no, I'm really pleased. That's, for me, that's been the highlights of this whole project, just walking in and seeing, wow.
After a total spend of £44,000, I am so eager to see if Lorraine's homework's paid off. We've invited two local property experts to take a look.
Huge difference. Done a great job. Obviously, new kitchen and bathroom all done to a very, very high standard with new carpets throughout the property.
There's a feeling of space and light, so that's good, and it will attract first-time buyers and, you know, landlords as well.
This property should achieve around £450 per calendar month.
I think I would achieve a rental value of £400 per calendar month.
Well, that's pretty good. I mean, I hadn't looked at renting, but it's good to know. In case it doesn't sell.
Taking the higher valuation of £450, that would bring a massive yield of around 12%. Will the sought-after sale price be as impressive?
I would value this property at £65,000.
A property like this should achieve around £70,000 in the current market.
Little on the low side. A couple of agents came around last week and they we're at the 70 mark. Probably Home Report would be 73, 75, but we'd look to get around 70. So, but fingers crossed, it'll be more my side than this.
Lorraine may not be all that impressed with the lower valuation of 65,000, but that would still give her a possible profit of £21,000, not to be sniffed at on your first property project.
I'm really pleased with how it's turned out. The flat looks great. And there was no major headaches. So if they were all like this, this would be my full-time career. But for now, back to London.